Hey guys, welcome back to Weld.com. So I had somebody reach out to me and ask me, how do you go about doing square tube corner joints and everything? They want to maintain the end. You know, they put the weld on there, and then by the time they get on there, the weld's either too weak or, you know, they can't blend it right. So I just kind of want to just do a quick video demo on how I typically do my my 90 degree corners with square tube. It seems pretty simple, but we'll go ahead and get started. Hopefully this is going to answer his question as well as some of the other viewers. So the first thing I want to do, because I'm making a 90 degree corner here, is I want to make sure that both of my miters are 45. So just double check your miters, make sure they're good. I mean, you can run into problems there. Both of these are cut, you know, right at 45 degrees, so we're good here. The next thing I want to do is I'm just going to put a small bevel in here. The one mistake a lot of people make is they'll join this together and then they just weld that top seam up, and then once they grind it back flush, you know, you'll get a crack down the center here because you didn't have enough of that wire to punch in. So I like to put a small bevel on there, just something that once I take the top reinforcement of that weld off, I still have weld inside of the material. Now I'm going to do that to all three sides. I'm also going to knock this corner back. Another mistake people make is they just weld that outside seam up, and then once they grind everything, you get a crack there as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a small bevel on each one of these. I'll get it all tacked up, get it fixtured up to my 90 degrees, wherever these corners meet, and I'm going to just knock this corner down. Today I'm going to use a 60 grit flap disc from Weiler just to take care of all the prep work, and then make sure you remove the mill scale as well, because taking the mill scale off is going to allow that puddle to flow a little bit smoother. So now I just want to do a fit up. So I'm going to set this up here. I'm just going to match the edges up. So here's our nice little bevel we got. We're going to weld this in. My intent with this is to kind of overfill this joint. That way when I take the grinder and blend everything back smooth, everything ties back in flush to the surface. If I have any low spots in here, you can just take the MIG gun and fill those up, or whatever process you're using, bring them up above flush. That way when we take them down, everything's nice and flat. I'm going to go ahead and use this fireball square here to make sure that I stay at that 90 degree corner that I want. Okay, now I've got a nice little area to fill in, so I'll probably, because I have the fireball square in here, I don't have to worry about distortion. I'm going to weld this side up right here. I'm going to knock this corner completely off, and then we'll do the same thing to the other side. So today we're going to run some Select Arc 70S6 wire, 035 diameter. Running about 300 inches a minute on the wire feed speed and 20 volts on the Everlast Lightning MTS-275. So we got the weld in here. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and knock this back corner back a little bit. So all I wanna do is knock this down to where it's about 1/4 inch, 3/8 wide of a flat spot right in here, because that way I can build that corner up and then I'll be able to shape it back or radius this corner, whichever the case may be. All right, now that it's flattened out, I'm just gonna go and do a vertical down on this. Just need to build up some weld metal. It's gonna punch in far enough to keep that corner of the structural integrity. And then once we get to the, we'll weld out the other side, and then we'll go ahead and be able to blend all this out. Now that I have two sides welded up, I can go ahead and bust the clamps off, take the fireball square off, weld out the beveled side and then that inside corner, and then we'll go ahead and get to the blending. So what I'm gonna do now is just knock the high spots down and blend all this in, taking the grinder and just pulling straight down. I don't wanna go back and forth because that's what's gonna cause that dip, that Coke bottle effect. Same thing on the outside. I'm just gonna follow that natural contour of the radius of that square tube. So I'm just gonna make several strokes going this way, come back on the opposite side, several strokes this way, and just kind of blend it out nice and neat. Same thing on this corner here. Once we get done, it should look relatively clean, smooth, almost like this piece was molded together. Other than the weld on the interior, we're gonna leave that one. We got all three sides done. Everything came out nice and smooth. Followed the contour. Again, don't take that grinder and run it back and forth over the same spot. Just, you know, light strokes, pulling each time, kind of follow that radius, follow that natural contour. Notice that I didn't just focus in this area, I tapered it back. That way, if there is a slight bit of taper in the material, it'll kind of break it up visually with the eye. It's all about aesthetics here. I've done a lot of gates, handrails, desks, tables, all kinds of stuff using this same method. It really turns out well. Once you get done with all this, you can go ahead and hit it back up with a DA, and then once you powder coat it or paint it, it'll look like a seamless transition. I'm gonna go ahead and attempt to clean up the inside corners a little bit. Like I said, this weld is going to stay. There's no reason to take that weld out. You can if you want to get in there with a little burr bit and spend, you know, take the time with it, but that's special tooling. We're just using the grinder today for this one. So everything turned out nice and clean. We got a nice 90 degree corner on the outside there. Like I said, if you hit it up with like a little DA with some sandpaper on there, just to kind of blend that in just a little bit more as far as the striations in there, kind of break up that scratch pattern, or even drop up to a higher grit on the sandpaper with your flapper wheel. You really can't tell the difference that was ever welded on those three sides. It's a nice smooth transition. So the sides that typically get exposed to, you know, whoever's gonna be viewing the piece, that's typically where I do it, kind of pay attention to that. You can even do this technique with stainless steel if you're going to buff that to a mirror polish. It works really good. The key to it is to make sure that you don't have any undercut and you don't have any underfill. If that happens, it's not a big issue because you can always just go back and fill in a little bit more weld metal in the low spots and then blend it back out again. So I hope that answers the questions. Hope you guys learned something along the way. You know, try it out, let me know what you think of it. If you guys got any questions, comments, concerns, feel free to drop them down there in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. And until next time, make every weld better than your last.